In this video, I will show you how to paint a sunflower in 3 steps using alla prima method of painting, also known as wet on wet. Hello, I'm Brianna West and welcome to my channel where I post weekly painting videos and share my painting tips. If this is a type of content you are looking for, make sure to click on the subscribe button and bell icon below to get notified when I post new videos. For this painting, I'll break down the process into 3 separate steps. Step 1. Transparent layer. In step 1, I start the painting by making a grid with Indian yellow, which is the lightest transparent color on my palette. Drawing a grid allows me to capture the image more accurately. You can see the gridded source image on the upper left corner of your screen. If you like to paint along with me, you can download the image from the link listed in the description below. The first layer of this painting is done loosely in transparent colors with no hard edges. The purpose of the transparent layer is to cover the white of the painting surface as quickly as possible. Transparent colors are applied with a mixture of linseed oil and gamsol. This creates a colorful, slick surface that will allow the second layer of opaque colors to go on smoothly and intermingle with the lower layer colors. I try to take my time in this phase to really get the color relations and values right. For instance, I'll put warm colors next to cool colors, light next to dark, and so forth. In step 2, after having the surface covered with transparent colors, it is time to draw the main shapes of the image with the rubber tip tool. This step is optional and can be used if a more precise copy of the source image is desired. Leave a comment below if you use a similar method in your paintings. Step 3, top layer with opaque colors. In this phase, my main focus is on the following 5 components: shapes, values, color relations, edges, and brushwork. I look for interesting abstract shapes in dark and light values. This sometimes referred to as no tan, which means light and dark harmony. For values, I make sure to have both the darkest darks and the lightest lights in the painting. For the color relations, I look for opportunities to have cooler hues next to warmer hues, or have color complements next to each other. I make softer edges for the objects that are on the background and harder edges for the objects that are in the foreground. I try to vary my brushwork to add interest and texture to the entire surface of the painting. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you like this video, please click on the like button and share with your artist friends. I post new painting videos weekly and share tips on various painting topics. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button and bell icon below to be notified when new videos are posted. Also, leave a comment below of the type of painting you would like to see. For instance, you can say seascapes or still life. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in my next video.